A small simple plastic piece can save the life or an airway. In this video, we will demonstrate insertion for the oropharyngeal airway. Oropharyngeal airway will be used for patients who are unconscious, that they cannot they don't have gag reflex, so they will not vomit. You can use also the oral oropharyngeal airway for the intubated patient to prevent biting of the tube. There is different sizes. We need to select the proper size. There is two techniques to insert oropharyngeal airway. Today we will demonstrate both of them. How to select the proper size for the oropharyngeal airway? By measuring from the patient's ear lobe or angle of the jaw to the corner of the mouth. An oropharyngeal airway that is too small, it may push the tongue into the oropharynx and cause obstruction. And the large one, the too large one, it might obstruct the trachea. So we need to select the proper size. So the first technique based on the using of the tongue depressor, and you will insert the oropharyngeal airway as it will be placed in the patient mouth. There is actually another method which is the most common we are using, which you will insert the oropharyngeal airway in the opposite placement. Then as the tip of the oropharyngeal airway reach the posterior wall of the pharynx, we will rotate the oropharyngeal 180 degrees while advancing it into the proper position. We need to make sure that the flange of the oropharyngeal airway is stable and positioned securely on the patient's lips. Hope you find the video useful. Thank you so much.